Avocado, Persea Americana. The avocado is one of the most valued fruits in the world, being discovered back in the day around 500 BC by the Aztecs in Mesoamerican times. It's a source of good fat, also known as monounsaturated fat. This type of fat helps maintain your cholesterol levels healthy, a healthy snack for a healthy life. But why is the avocado loved by many people? First, it's been proven as a fact that avocados are the most popular ingredient to include in Super Bowl parties. Guacamole is the most known dip to be consumed by people. It's been stated that over 200 million pounds of avocados are sold and consumed on Super Bowl Sunday. Plus, not only are avocados loved on meals, appetizers, and other foods, but you can use it on your face and even your hair. Avocados are loaded with different types of vitamins, such as vitamin K, vitamin C, vitamin E, amongst other healthy vitamins. All these vitamins make the avocado a superfood. An avocado is so rich, it has more potassium than a banana. Imagine being superior to a banana. Avocados are also high in fiber. So next time, instead of using laxatives and saying it's for your sister, just eat a bunch of avocados instead. How do avocados help your hair? Well, they hydrate it. They contain natural oils and won't damage your hair like the store products do. For a proper hair care, act as if you are preparing a nice bowl of guacamole and mush it. Do not mix the tomatoes with the onion, though. Do not. Absolutely do not. Once the avocado is nicely mushed, mix a hint of coconut oil and spread it all over your hair. Wait 30 minutes with a shower cap and relax. Have leftover avocado spread? No worries! You can also use it on your face and skin for a more moisturized and smoother feel, just how Jeffrey likes it. Once time is up, just rinse with cool water and shampoo. Your hair and skin should feel so fine now. After doing some research, I have discovered exactly why the avocado pricing has increased so much over the years. It's because avocados require approximately 80 liters of water in order to produce about 1 kilogram of avocados. It's literally in their name. Agua literally means water in Spanish. Avocados are very sensitive to where they grow, which is why only in Mexico and Central America they are produced more easily, so there's more cost in transport also. Although avocados are a good source of fat, in reality, it is hurting our ecosystem. It hurts me to say this because of my love for the avocado. Due to all the water that the plants consume in order to produce, various regions in Mexico and Central America have to go through drought. This hurts everyone as water is an important source for everyday use. Avocados take a long time to grow, up to 5 to 13 years, if planted by seed, which can cause impatience for producers and consumers worldwide. As mentioned before, avocados are very sensitive, and if they don't receive that correct amount of sunlight, they tend to go bad. In a few seconds here, you will learn more about the positives of the avocado plant with some celebrity guests you may love. But first, a few words from our sponsors.
Avocados from Mexico.
For this documentary, I had the privilege to interview a well-known man, Brian Q. Quinn, aka Q. You may know him from one of America's most watched TV shows, Impractical Jokers. Due to COVID, I was not able to meet up with him in person. However, here he is here with me today via webcam. Q, buddy, say hello to the public.
Hey everyone, happy to be here on this fine day.
Glad to hear that. Anyways, we are here today to talk about your love for the avocados. I'm sure you have some fun facts.
Oh yeah, yeah. Gotta love them.
So my first question for you, what do you like best about this exotic fruit?
I think that you can make anything out of it. You do know the deep history of the famous avocado.
Not really, no, but I'm sure you were going to tell us, right?
Why, of course. First and foremost, avocado, when discovered by the Aztecs, they named it ajucado. It was not until the Spanish conquistadors arrived they named it the aguacate. And Americans translated it to what we know today as avocado.
That is fascinating. And tell me, why do you know so much of this?
Well, what can I say? I'm what you call an avocado nerd.
Wow, very nice.
You know, some people back then would call it an alligator pear, because of its shape of a pear and the textured skin and all. Did you also know that avocados weren't introduced to Americans till about 1950s with the move of many Latino immigrants?
Wow, I can only imagine. Well, is there anything else you would like to add that would conclude our meeting?
Oh yeah, one more thing actually. Have you heard the avocado song?
No, I haven't. What is it?
Peel the avocado, peel the avocado, peel the avocado, peel the avocado. Guacamole, 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 guacamole. Mix the tomatoes with the onions, mix the tomatoes with the onions, and you dice it up, dice it up. Ahora lo digo en español para ustedes.
In conclusion, avocados are an excellent source of monounsaturated fat, which helps us but hurts our ecosystem from all the obsession of supply and demand to get to us. So next time you eat one, do not waste it. Enjoy it and thank farmers worldwide who work hard to bring these to our table.